The President, please be seated.
Mesdames et Messieurs, veuillez vous asseoir.
Le Président. The court is now in session.
Nous reprenons l'audience.
The chamber will conduct a hearing on the fact regarding the
mener cette audience
tortures
sur le
and
thème
the methods of
torture et des méthodes de torture
S21.
Before
we proceed with
avant
the proceedings, we would like the greffiers to verify the attendance
je
of the parties
de vérifier
to the proceedings
quelles sont
in
les
today's
parties
session.
Présentes aux fins du compte rendu.
The greffier,
greffier,
Mr. President,
Monsieur le
the
Président,
parties to the proceedings today are all present except
sont présentes à l'exception
the defense lawyer, Mr. Casavoot,
Monsieur
who is
Casavoot,
absent.
Conseil
Mr. President, thank
la
you,
défense.
Mr. Greffier.
Le Président, je vous remercie, Monsieur le
Mr. Hong Kum-soon, we note your presence.
Maître
the floor is yours.
Nous remarquons que vous souhaitez intervenir.
Mr. Hong Kum-soon, thank you, Mr. President.
Maître
I would like
remercie,
to introduce the member of our
présenter
group
les membres
4,
de notre
Ms.
Groupe,
Jessica,
groupe 4,
who is in place of Mr. Pierre Olivier Sûr.
Qui remplace Monsieur Olivier Sûr.
Mr. Hong Kum-soon, thank you.
Maître Hong Kum-soon, je vous remercie.
Le Président.
Le Président.
The President,
the
security guards, please bring
les gardes responsables de la sécurité
to the dock.
D'amener ce dernier à la barre.
The President. The Chamber would like to respond to the request to seek clarification from the co-prosecutor raised yesterday concerning the plan or the purpose of the hearings of the trial chamber and how it would be conducted. In the future concerning the functioning of S21 and
le thème du fonctionnement de S21 et de Chung-hek
and the Presor
ainsi
Security
que
Office.
Du centre de sécurité
the Chamber
de
would like to inform
nous souhaiterions
the co-prosecutors and the parties to the proceedings that the Chamber still maintains its position as decided
position
in the previous ruling concerning the scheduling of the hearing
précédente
and
concernant
by way of separating
le calendrier
the
des
functionings of S21
à savoir,
and the functioning of S21
et le fonctionnement de S24
we can call it the recorrection camp
ou ce que l'on appelle aussi
number
le
two,
centre de rééducation de Presaw
functioning of S21 and Chung-hek
fonctionnement de S21 et de Chung-hek
would follow the same orders by first starting with
ordre,
the arrest
d'abord à commencer
the
par l'arrestation le
of the people arrested and the detention of the prisoners. So we have already conducted this. And also it is followed
thèmes.
By tortures
Ce thème sera suivi par celui
and
de la
after
torture.
Questionings on the tortures, then Après there are subtopics
une série de questions posées
listed
sur le thème
in
de la torture.
The indictment of the co-investigating judges. For example, the enslavement, the sexual abuse,
un certain nombre de sous-thèmes,
and persecution,
à savoir
and other inhumane violations or treatments
de nature,
found by the co-investigating judges. And they form the basis for charges in the indictment.
Qui constitue
and number three, about the killing. So we divide this topic into two, the killing
ailleurs,
at S21 office and surrounding the S21 office. And
thèmes,
number two, the killing at
S21
Act.
Premièrement, et deuxièmement, les
the chamber would like to also notify the party that the chamber has determined time for each party to put questions
pour permettre à chaque partie
regarding
de poser
the above mentioned facts to the accused. 3 hours for the prosecutors, 3 hours for the civil party, 4 hours
for
the defense counsel.
Pour les conseils de la défense.
So, please follow the
nous vous invitons
time frames
à respecter
mentioned.
Les temps de parole qui viennent d'être mentionnés.
So, Monsieur,
Mr. President, we note your presence, the co-prosecutor, you take the floor.
Monsieur le co-procureur, vous souhaitez
prendre
la
good morning, Mr. President, Your Honours and Counsel. Thank you for that guidance. Just so that I am clear, is it the case that in relation to the full topic of the functioning of S21, the prosecution would receive certainly a guiding term of 3 hours? And if that's correct, Your Honours, I would ask that the questioning from the co-prosecutors, if that could commence, bearing in mind we have today's hearing and tomorrow, that would commence on Monday, first thing on Monday morning, the 22nd. The reason why I say that, Your Honour, is that obviously time is precious, and it's very important that all parties put forward effective questions that are not duplicative of what Your Honours have requested. And particularly, the prosecution would like to have that extra time if, in fact, Your Honours are finished by tomorrow afternoon, because we would like to put a number of documents to the accused. And the documents I'm referring to are documents with the accused's annotations on them that help support and confirm allegations that have been made in the indictment. Also, the prosecution would like to put forward a number of photographs that are particularly relevant to the activities of this accused. As Your Honour is aware, with the handling of documents in the courtroom, it's very important that all parties, including the prosecution, are very efficient with that. And today, it has been, in some instances, a complicated exercise. And what the prosecution would like to do is to be able to provide the accused and the defence copies of those documents they would like to refer to, which was requested in the trial management meeting. We think by doing that, that will enable that there's a familiarity with the documents, bearing in mind the case file is so large. And secondly, hopefully that would do away with a number of concerns that are raised in terms of objections. And we would also ask, Your Honour, that in relation to the time period that Your Honours consider, if, for example, the prosecution or other parties are dealing with a topic that's getting to the core truth of the matter, an important point, that be taken into consideration in looking at the time limits, bearing in mind that this is the central part of the case, and this may be the first and or the last most significant time that the prosecution may be able to question the accused on the facts that support or undermine the mitigating circumstances that have been put forward by the defendant in this case. And I think we all know what they are. So, Your Honours, for that questioning to go very smoothly, I would ask that we be allowed to review transcripts and provide documents and so that it's as effective as possible.
De manière à permettre de travailler de la manière la plus efficace qui soit.
The President.
Le président.
What has been raised by the international
co-procureur
is that it is actually an issue because of the our proceeding, which needs
notre procédure.
The documents or evidence or exhibits to be presented before the chamber in the form of a documentary or a video or film, which takes longer time than normal questioning. And this reflects the general view of the case more concretely than just ordinary questioning without showing the video or images. However, we are confident that during the proceeding, the trial chamber will endeavor to speed up the process of questioning by tomorrow by the chamber.
Visant à
so for the remaining days,
demain,
the chamber considers the parties have adequate times to do the further research and determines the lines of questionings to ensure they are not repetitive to the questions already raised by the chamber. The second issue, they would have the opportunity to prepare the documents tentatively to be submitted before the chamber during the questioning. And the third issue, the time allocation is just a basis for us to try to expedite the proceeding.
Visant à nous permettre d'accélérer les travaux.
In cases where the chamber considers the ability and the necessity to present the documents beyond the time allocation determined by the chamber, the chamber will set further timed according to the situation so that the party has the ability to present the documents
pour permettre au parti de présenter les documents.
So this is the practice instruction from the
Voici
chamber.
Les instructions pratiques.
I'm wondering whether the co-procureur think it is suitable. I would like now to give the floor to Judge Cartwright first.
Je souhaiterais tout d'abord donner la parole
Thank you, Mr.
à Madame
President. I'm not sure if it came through in the Khmer or not, but I think the trial chamber would be very grateful if any documents that are to be distributed are prepared and made available to the relevant parties and to the trial chamber over the next 2 or 3 days. Rather than receiving them as you produce them in court. And secondly, I think that we'll see how the questioning goes tomorrow and decide whether to give you until Monday to begin your questioning. Is that acceptable, President?
Est-ce que ceci vous semble acceptable, Monsieur le Président?
The President,
le Président.
I agree with your proposal.
Je suis d'accord avec votre proposition.
Thank you, Your Honours. That is clear.
C'est clair.
In relation to the time limit, even taking into account the use of documents, I think with that extra time to prepare, the prosecution will be able to predict reasonably well the amount of time required, including the presentation of the documents. So I would ask, in light of Your Honour's discipline in terms of the timeline, but also flexibility in terms of the issues, that at the end of Your Honour's questioning, that we the parties briefly be able to submit the length of time they think would be appropriate, and if Your Honour could review that. Also, Your Honours, in terms of planning, in terms of presentation of documents to the chamber, to the parties, in terms of reviewing, etc. I would just ask that Your Honours, throughout the day, depending on how the proceedings progress, reconsider providing an answer as to whether or not the prosecution would question tomorrow or Monday, because, as Your Honours are aware, it makes a significant difference in terms of the workload and disclosure to the parties, bearing in mind we'll be in court during the day.
De charge de travail qui se pose, également de divulgation d'informations, et nous vous tiendrons informés de ces éléments d'ici demain. Le président.
The president, I noticed the presence of François Roux. You take the floor.
Vous souhaitez intervenir, je vous en prie.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Thank you, Your Honour, says Mr. Roux.
Deux observations.
I have two comments.
Premièrement, Monsieur le Président,
firstly,
Madame, Monsieur, pour ma part, je suis un peu
as
surpris
far as I'm concerned, I must voice
que le bureau des coprocureurs,
my surprise at the fact that
mais
the
également les
parties office,
civiles,
but also the civil parties
manifestent si peu de confiance dans la Chambre qu'ils estiment devoir intervenir aussi longuement pour poser des questions à l'accusé après que la Chambre ait, pour sa part, procédé à des interrogatoires aussi complets. Je ne comprends pas cela. Dans ma compréhension des règles, à partir du moment où la Chambre pose très largement des questions à l'accusé, il me semblait que les parties n'avaient à poser que quelques questions complémentaires et non pas à refaire à leur manière le travail déjà fait par la Chambre. Première observation. Deuxième observation, je n'ai pas l'habitude de critiquer les décisions que vous rendez. Je ne le ferai donc pas, mais je veux seulement qu'il soit noté qu'il me semble qu'il y a un malentendu. Je ne peux pas vraiment comprendre qu'alors que procureur et partie civile disposeraient de 6 heures pour interroger à leur tour l'accusé, la défense n'aurait quant à elle que 4 heures, c'est-à-dire à peine un peu plus de la moitié du temps de ses contradicteurs. Le minimum, me semble-t-il, est que la défense ait toujours le même temps de parole, par principe, que celui de l'ensemble de ses contradicteurs. Vous aurez observé qu'en ce qui concerne les témoins, la défense a toujours dit qu'elle n'aura que 4 jours de témoignage, tandis qu'on est à plus d'un mois pour les bureaux des coprocureurs. Tout le monde aura remarqué la composition des équipes du procureur et des parties civiles et la composition de l'équipe de la défense. Je voudrais de temps en temps que dans ce procès, on se rappelle que même quand on est accusé des crimes les plus graves, on a le droit à une défense équitable et qu'une défense équitable passe au minimum par un temps de parole équitable et équilibré par rapport à ces contradicteurs. Je l'ai dit, la décision est rendue, je ne la conteste pas, je demande seulement que soit mentionnée au procès-verbal de notre audience les réserves expresses de la défense par rapport à ce déséquilibre afin qu'en cas d'appel éventuel, nous puissions soumettre ce débat à la Chambre d'appel. Je vous remercie.
Thank you, Your Honour. If I can just briefly to respond to those remarks. Firstly, I think it should be made absolutely clear that the prosecution has complete trust in this chamber in the way the proceedings have been conducted. The prosecution takes absolute exception to those remarks. We find them highly objectionable. And we make it very clear we disassociate ourselves from those remarks, absolutely.
Absolument pas nous y associer.
My friend is well aware that different parties to these proceedings have different roles.
Les différentes parties à la procédure.
We're all aware of the trial chamber's role. And the prosecution has a role and a duty under the statute and under the rules to ensure that the charges in the closing order are proved beyond reasonable doubt. And that's an independent duty of Your Honour's duty to make a finding beyond reasonable doubt. If we don't vigorously explore and further the evidence to the level the prosecution believe it's required to prove all aspects beyond its reasonable doubt. The prosecution is not doing its duty. It's not doing its duty to the Cambodian people, nor to this court, nor to the chamber. The fact that parties have questions above and beyond or different to the trial chamber has got nothing at all to do with the lack of trust of the trial chamber. It's got to do with the amount of evidence in this case, the complexity, the intricateness of the issues. I think it's fair to say that anyone dealing with a case of this size cannot think of every single aspect that's required. That's human nature, that's logical.
Du dossier.
C'est Your Honours, the prosecution have made a commitment and
se sont engagés
supported all of the trial management decisions that Your Honours have made in relation to time limits, the questioning of witnesses particularly. In fact, at the trial management meeting last Thursday, it was the prosecution that proposed those time limits in order that the trial can be finished in a reasonable period of time. So, it is not a prosecutor or a prosecution office that wants to question for the sake of it. The prosecution just wants to assist the chamber in ascertaining the truth of the matter. And I repeat, we take great exception to those remarks by the defense. Secondly, and I'll just be brief, the prosecutors and the civil parties have a very different role. The civil parties and their representation don't have a duty to prove charges beyond reasonable doubt, but the prosecution does. So to equate, to say that the civil parties and the prosecutor are in some way one super prosecution office and the defense have to have the exact amount of time. As a general rule, I don't think that should be found
juste.
Because the prosecution have a duty under the rules and the statute, which is quite independent
les tâches des uns et des autres sont très différentes, comme il découle du statut et des règles.
The President, give the floor now to the civil party lawyer.
Ms. Rabesandratana, Mr. President, thank you.
Je voudrais intervenir pour préciser qu'effectivement, clarify en tant que partie civile, that nous ne sommes pas lawyer, bis repetita de l'accusation, que nous avons une place particulière qui est autonome
which is independent,
et que notre rôle, c'est d'expliquer et de faire valoir le point de vue
to
de la victime,
the victim's
ce
point
qui
of
est tout à fait différent
which is completely different
de,
from,
effectivement, de la
indeed,
place et du rôle
from
du,
the role
du procureur
of, prosecutor.
Et que nous ne nous substituons
we
pas
are not,
et nous n'avons pas à nous substituer à l'accusation.
Wish to
par contre, je pense que nous apportons une parole
however,
qui est une parole de terrain
information coming et, from the field,
qui est une qui est une plus-value
is,
par rapport à des analyses de professionnels, d'experts, d'historiens, de sociologues. Nous apportons une autre vérité.
We
voilà ce que je voulais vous expliquer par rapport
au,
à la place de la partie civile, qui
ne
doit pas
lawyers,
être, je crois, amalgamée
which of course should
avec,
not be
et d'ailleurs,
confused,
enfin, votre décision,
with,
je pense... le laisse entendre avec le rôle du procureur.
The role of the prosecutor.
The President, I noticed the presence of a civil party lawyer. Civil party lawyer. Thank you, Mr. President.
Avocat des partis civils.
Your honors.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Thank you for allowing me
Monsieur
to give my
juges,
opinions.
Merci.
I have two important points
à ce stade, je voudrais dire deux choses.
Concerning the rights of the parties.
Concernant les droits des partis.
The lawyer has said, the defense lawyer has said
l'avocat de la défense
about the right of his client that he has his full rights to defend himself. But for us, the lawyers of the civil party,
mais
we also have
côté,
to think of the
civils,
rights of our
aussi,
civil parties.
Nous devons aussi de rappeler les droits des partis civils.
And he cannot combine the time allocation between the co-prosecutors and the civil parties lawyers and to compare to his time allocation. The defense is a defense for the accused. It's one party. And the co-prosecutors, as
partie,
he said, is a separate
partie,
entity. And we, the civil parties lawyers, is a separate
civiles.
Independent party to represent the views of our clients. So,
ici pour,
these are three separate
clients.
Distinct parties, and the time allocation cannot be combined between the civil parties lawyers and the co-prosecutors.
Ensemble le temps de parole des coprocureurs et des parties civiles.
And actually, if we compare each party, it means the defense counsel has one more hour
en fait,
than the civil
parties
lawyers' time allocation.
Parties.
The President, thank you for your remark.
Merci. Le Président, merci pour ses remarques.
Now, the Chamber will not allow any further discussion
nous allons,
on this particular issue.
Ce débat sur cette question.
Now it is time to proceed with the questionings on the fact regarding the torture at S21.
Et cette fois, les actes de torture commis à S21.
The President, Mr. Kangkeiu, can you describe the methods applied by you and your deputies at S21 regarding the tortures
technique de torture qui est employée par vous et vos subordonnés
in interrogating a lot of prisoners who were detained because the number reached more than 10,000. So please elaborate about the methods and how you managed such interrogation.
Quelles étaient donc les techniques de torture employées lors des interrogatoires?
The accused.
Réponse.
Mr. President, S21. Was the combination of two
Monsieur
units.
S21
it was first the division, the police office of division 703, sometimes not called 703. It office 03.
au bureau 03, comme l'a appelé aussi.
Operated in Takmao prison and another special prison at Samdak Krompria Sisowat Monirate.
Prison à Sisowat Monirate.
On the 10th, then we combined the units
ensuite,
together
and at
that time,
Nat
asked me to teach cadres of Division 703 on how to torture,
to
interrogate,
d'interrogatoire.
I worked together with other people. And later on, the operation moved smoothly alongside with one another.
Puis plus tard,
and
les deux ont
who was assigned to interrogate prisoners was the responsibility of Nat.
C'est Nat qui
when Nat
les
left,
aux interrogatoires. Une fois que
Nat
I est parti,
managed
c'est moi
the work by assigning Comrade Ho to handle the tasks for the special people
pour,
who trusted by the superior Pon was assigned to
Bonne,
handle the duty. So when Nat
was
the chairman, I was the one in charge of
moi,
educating people, cadres from Division 703 and reviewed documents
j'étais aussi responsable de
regarding the key person, Mr. Saw Porn.
Pour ce qui est des personnes clés, il y avait Saw Porn.
And later on,
et plus tard,
the interrogation had to be fully managed by me. If I did not satisfy with some documents, then
si
I had to transfer those documents to the units.
Je transférais les documents à
and
l'unité.
When Nat left, then the full operation was under my control.
Parti,
so now I would like to elaborate on how people
je
were interrogated. Before tortures were subjected to be inflicted on any prisoner, I educated interrogators to use politics and to study the prisoner's background by way of asking of other questionings rather than resorting to
torture.
And in short, I did allow people to torture people in three four ways. First, by beating, beating by with
les coups à l'aide
lashes or whip or other kind of beating.
Portés à l'aide de fouet ou d'autres sortes
number
de coups.
Two, I allowed them to electrocute the prisoner by using the electric telephone.
Avec des
and
fils
number three,
téléphoniques. Trois,
I allowed the interrogators to pour water into the nostrils
dans
but of the prisoners, but I forgot, I have forgotten the fourth method. The president, please listen again to
écoutez,
the question.
Écoutez bien ma question.
The question is about
ma question
the
porte sur
management, administering of
the
interrogators at S21 to interrogate huge number of prisoners who were sent to S21 because yesterday you said at least 12,380 people were sent to S21, although the number could be higher because there would be more people included if there were enough surviving documents to support. So the question is, how you manage the interrogators to interrogate such a high number of prisoners? So it is more about the interrogation rather than the torture.
Donc ce qui m'intéresse pour l'instant, c'est davantage
thank you, Mr. President,
les interrogatoires en tant que tels, plutôt que la torture.
l'accusé.
The interrogation team divided into three groups, even when Nat was still there. The number one, the cold group, the hot group, and the chewing group. For the cold group, tortures were not applied. For the hot group, their hands were hot, so they would beat the prisoners immediately if the confession were not extracted as they wanted. For the chewing team, they needed more time to interrogate the prisoners, and it took long term. Some prisoners were subjected to long-term torturing and interrogation before we could get the confession. And when Nat left, I added a few more methods. I added the special group to interrogate people who were very important, and that the upper echelon would like to know more about those people. So I educated Comrade Pon to be able to interrogate such people. I only used Brother Mom Nai as assistant in interrogation. So he was not, he did not belong to any particular interrogation team. So the normal interrogation group comprised of three main groups.
Normalement
the president.
Composé de trois
personnes. If you said there were three groups, how many people were in each group?
Combien y avait-il d'interrogateurs dans chaque groupe? For example,
people in the cold group or hot group or chewing group, were there any sub-groups within each group?
Y avait-il dans chacun de ces groupes des sous-groupes?
The accused, Mr. President. When Nat was still in charge, I was not fully aware or grasp the detail of how many people were in each group.
Du nombre d'interrogateurs dans chacun des
and I was only prepared to just review the documents to be ready to receive more prisoners.
À examiner les documents.
The president, question. In general, in the cold group, for example, how many people were there in the group and how many people were there in the hot group? Because during the passage of time, the number of people in each group might vary.
Au fil du temps, il se peut que le nombre d'interrogateurs dans chaque groupe ait changé.
The accused, Mr. President, it is difficult to estimate how many people were in each group because I focused mainly on the essence of the confession, whether further confessions are needed. So I am not in control of how many people were there in each group, but in the cold group, I guess there were about 5 to 6 people, and there were also few people in the hot group, maybe 4 to 5. I remember the hottest person in the group was Comrade Doi, and for the chewing group, Comrade Tet was the team leader. The President,
question.
You also stated earlier, or maybe in several occasions already, and since it was not yet related to the fact, I may have to ask you again concerning the security office of
S21.
Were there any arrangements to form a female interrogators group, and if they did exist, when were
et si ce groupe a existé?
When was the group formed?
Quand a-t-il été formé?
The accused, réponse. Mr. President. The female interrogators were formed
oui,
because
il y a eu un groupe de femmes interrogatrices
abuse on a female detainee by a male interrogator.
Détenue.
And at that time, I asked for permission from my superior to include the wife of the cadres of S21 to form an interrogator.
Des femmes de cadre
group.
De
at the beginning, there were five people.
Au début, ce groupe comprenait
we have
the
wives of Comrade Hoare as the Hoare, chief of
la
the leader
était
and
la
Comrade
Mott's
wife.
Il y avait aussi la femme de Mott qui en faisait partie.
And Comrade Mott himself was the secretary
Mott lui-même était
of
le secrétaire
the battalion of the sewing section. So my superior agreed.
De
then, when
mes supérieurs m'ont donné cette
autorisation, the superior wanted to arrest one of the cadre, then the wife of that cadre was also arrested. Then
et
later
quand
on, Nun Hui, the member
tard,
of this S21's committee in charge of S21 and S24, then his wife and his child also were arrested.
Arrêté, ainsi
and
que
the other three interrogators still remained.
Il est resté après cela trois femmes interrogatrices.
Ron, and they lived until we departed on the 7th of January 1979. So only three interrogators remained with us until 7th January.
Restés jusqu'au bout.
Mr. President, thank you.
Le président, merci.
You always stated about the method of interrogating the detainee, which include the three main tactics, the cold, the hot, and the chewing approach. So these approaches have been allocated to only the interrogators. Do I understand that correctly? They accused the allocation of groups and torturing methods are interrelated. The group were formed according to the methods of torture, as what you just mentioned.
De torture, comme vous venez de le dire,
the President, you all often said, and today it is time to clarify the three methods of
torture.
Can you tell the court the details of how each method was applied, for example, the cold method, and in which situation was it applied, and when was
froide,
the hot method was employed, and in which case? The accused, the three methods operated according to the activity line which was approved.
Selon la ligne organisationnelle qui était approuvée.
In general, it started
générale,
with the beginning with just soft questioning by way of understanding, trying to understanding the people who would be answering to us. Then after understanding the situation, then they would start further questions, then later on, if they could not really solve the problem through way of cool method,
si
the hot method would
froide,
be introduced.
Chaude.
A surviving book compiled by our interrogator
des documents
really clarifies
par
this
qui existe encore aujourd'hui.
Matter.
Il ressort clairement la
in conclusion,
dont ces méthodes étaient appliquées.
Only I exercised or used the one single cold method to interrogate Khoitun. And I don't believe that other people maintain the cold method like I did. they needed to use the chewing method.
And Toi, employé la méthode de la mastication. Et Toi,
when chewing method was not the case in extracting confession, then Toi would seek hot method, and if the other
et
two groups could not really solve any problem, then they would refer to Toi. To the last and ultimate method by way of chewing
toic, method. En, comme dernière, comme dernier recours pour interroger le détenu.
The President, when you and your deputy assigned different groups of interrogators and assigned a particular task to them,
des interrogateurs et
my question is, can I say that it is a systematic way of interrogating each prisoner at S21?
Vous aviez une méthode systématique pour l'interrogatoire des prisonniers de S21?
The accused. It is fair to say that the interrogation at S21 was done systematically,
oui,
because when Hoy, when Comrade Ho started to help me with the interrogation, then they classified people who would be taken away immediately or people who would be kept long enough with the assistance of the upper echelon. Then these were consistent with the operation within S21 and the advice from the upper echelon. So I could say that it is more a system way of doing
things.
Donc
en place tout un système, a systematic pour interroger les détenus.
The President, you said that the interrogators were classified into three groups, and in each group there were about 5 to 6 people.
Groupe, il y avait,
so
personnes.
How could the prisoners were organized? For example,
comment
after
les choses
prisoners
du côté des
were sent to S21, then each team would be rotated to question or interrogate the prisoners on a regular basis,
or
what would be the operation at the S21 to interrogate those prisoners? The accused,
réponse.
Mr. President. Interrogation at S21 took place by the what I can call the preliminary interrogation team.
Il y avait d'abord
this
un
team
préliminaire
would only ask
par une équipe qui ne faisait
questions
que poser
to
des
grasp
questions pour
the core essence of the confession, and then
Hall
would make a decision with consultation with me or made a decision alone whether the group those people would
si
be sent to a respective group, for example, the cold group or the hot
froide,
or the chewing.
And
again, if any prisoner was sent to the cool
encore
group and then the cool group could not handle the task,
froide,
then
the
group would refer to another two groups.
Prisonnier était
for the key people,
pour les
the key prisoners
les prisonniers
would be managed by the team managed by Comrade Pon.
C'est l'équipe dirigée par Pon
so the upper echelon said that these people were special. Then I would assign Pon to
spéciaux,
just monitor them.
Je leur assignais Pon.
The President.
Question.
Can you tell the Chamber about the situation of the interrogators in bringing the prisoners
les interrogateurs
for the interrogations from the
les prisonniers
holding place to the interrogation area? How was it done at S21?
D'interrogatoire. Comment cela se passait-il à S21?
The The accused, Mr. President, did not see the process personally. However, through my presumption, based on my experience at M13, the prisoner was hands were tied to the back and they were walked to the interrogation place. Then they would be shackled and the arms would be untied.
Et on leur déliait les mains.
This is the common practice.
C'était là la pratique
that I used to order people to do at M13.
Normalement appliquée à M13.
And I think a similar practice was done at S21. Although the practice had been done before I took control of S21.
Même si
this is based on the analysis of the situation.
Avant que je n'en devienne le directeur.
The President, yesterday you stated that the operation at S21 was clearly designated between the Special Force for the Outer Defense and the prisoners' guards inside.
La force spéciale,
so they guarded the prisoners in the cells in the common rooms. And the question is, in the procedure of interrogating the prisoners,
et la suivante,
and the taking of the prisoner from the cell to the interrogation, did the interrogator went inside the room to take the prisoner to be interrogated, or this done was, or this job was done?
Il s'agissait des gardes qui emmenaient les prisonniers des cellules
by
aux salles
d'interrogatoire. The guard and the interrogator did not have to enter the room of the prisoner.
Comment est-ce que
cela what se passe? Is the mechanism for this?
Et les interrogateurs
was it the guard
dans les cellules
and shackled the prisoner and handed the prisoner to the interrogator who was waiting outside, or whether the interrogator went inside the room to get the prisoner
qui est entré dans la cellule
accused,
pour
President,
aller chercher le prisonnier.
I am still unclear l'accusé. On this matter because I did not witness it personally. However, through my analysis, I can conclude that the
cependant,
interrogator would go to the front door and waited at the front door because the, inside the room it was the authority of the guards
porte,
and the prisoner would be handed
de la salle,
through the interrogator at the front door, and then the interrogator
ensuite,
would walk the prisoner to the interrogation room.
Le garde enlevait les entraves du prisonnier, ensuite l'emmenait à l'interrogateur jusqu'à l'entrée de la pièce, et ensuite l'interrogateur emmenait les prisonniers
but probably, too quick, and I want to verify on this. So when the prisoner needed to be taken to the interrogation room,
emmener le prisonnier,
what was the arrangement?
Quelles étaient les dispositions
before the interrogation took place?
Le début de l'interrogatoire.
The accused, Mr.
L'accusé.
President.
Monsieur le Président.
In principle, whatever was necessary in order to ensure
en
that the prisoner did not protest
afin
and could not escape. So I could presume that when they arrived at the interrogation place, they would be shackled and then the arms would be untied. And if the prisoner agreed to confess and to write their confession, then they would be allowed to sit on the chair, and then their legs would be shackled to the chair, and then they would write their confession. If they did not confess to write, then they would be seated on the floor with their legs shackled.
Sinon, le prisonnier était obligé de se mettre.
In general, at the interrogation location, there were. Were there any torturing tools already prepared? For example, a clap or electrocution wire? Were those tools well prepared on the table, ready for the torture, or it could be
table,
a deterrent for the prisoner to confess,
afin de
the accused.
D'obliger
on this
le
matter,
prisonnier
it,
à
it was apparent
l'accusé.
When I was shown on the 28th of February 2008 during the reenactment, some interrogators said these were the
deterrents.
So I believed the clubs or the sticks were already prepared for the torture. And regarding the handheld telephone, I think every interrogator would have it.
Déjà sur la table, des
and about the plastic bags, I think it was rarely used by the interrogators. And pouring water was also seldom used. So in general, a clap was frequently used.
De l'eau sur
and also the handheld telephone for electrocution.
Donc, il y avait des
and
tenailles,
some tools like a big sword or knife was only displayed as
et
a deterrent.
D'autres outils comme des grands couteaux qui étaient simplement placés sur la table pour décourager.
The President, what was your observation on the practice?
Le Président.
And the
qu'avez-vous pu
handling
observer
of the prisoner from the holding cell to the interrogation location
entre la cellule où ils étaient détenus et la salle où avaient
and
lieu
that
les
they were tied or shackled at the interrogation room and the process of the interrogator walking them to the interrogation location and that before they were interrogated, their legs would be shackled to the table and before their handcuffs or hands or arms were untied. So who taught the interrogators the process of doing this, or whether it was initiated by themselves without receiving any training or instructions from anybody?
Sans avoir été formé par qui que ce soit.
Mr. President, I would respond in the general case.
Je vais vous répondre de manière.
And I did not want to say that I also talk about the special prison. Generally, this practice was carried on from the M13. That's from my experience. And from the for the Division 703, it was also a practice since its establishment.
Dans la
and they just
division,
followed it as
pratiqué.
A common practice from
et
one another.
D'une pratique communément répandue
so,
que
saying
les
whether
personnes suivaient
there were lessons or instructions, it's hard to say
division.
Because
donc,
there was no written document to practice. But
si
the practice was customary from the beginning,
écrit pour décrire la pratique à suivre.
And it happened
mais
in all the
départ,
police offices,
passé,
including the M13 office.
Dans
and the
Nico
upper
police,
echelon also approved, and I myself, the chairman
approuvé,
of the unit, I also approve of the practice.
J'approuvais la pratique.
The President, Mr. Kangek-il.
President, Monsieur Kangek-il.
Was you alone to teach the interrogation techniques to the interrogators at S21? Is that correct?
N'est-ce pas?
The accused, Mr. President. From the day I became the deputy,
à partir du moment où je suis
I was the
adjoint,
only one who taught the interrogation techniques to the interrogators.
Les interrogateurs
the President,
en matière de
your teaching on the techniques,
le
was it done frequently since the establishment of the S21 until the 6th of January 1979? The accused, Mr. President.
Monsieur le Président.
Talking about the interrogation techniques,
s'agissant des techniques
I taught for about a month or 2 to 3 weeks and about 2 hours per day. And then I walked around inspecting them, interrogating the prisoners. So later on, I did not train. However, in the end, I taught them the directions for interrogation.
Des orientations pour
they
ce
were
all
in the record
quant à la manière dont les
interrogatoires in the notebook
être
of Brother Momnai as he wrote during his training.
De Frère Momnai.
So, initially, I taught the interrogators
on trouve ce qu'il a écrit dans le
cadre de
later on,
when I taught the politics, also the directions in searching out the enemies, it was written in the book note of Brother Momnai. So the teaching was constant with these two particular points.
Avec ces deux axes particuliers d'intervention,
the President, you taught the interrogation techniques to the S21 interrogators.
Le Président, vous avez appris aux interrogateurs de S21 les techniques.
What you stated in the previous hearings, you also stated that you was the only one who examined, analyzed the confessions and reported to the upper echelon.
Et rendez compte au
can you tell the chamber,
pouvez-vous dire à la chambre
the form of interrogation? Was the interrogation categorized in separate forms based on the biography or the rank or the activities of the prisoners or based on the lines of traitors of those prisoners? Did you think about this or did you instruct your interrogators on the techniques for these particular types of prisoners?
À traiter des différents types de prisonniers.
The accused, Mr. President.
First, accusé, Monsieur le Président.
In instructing the interrogators to interrogate,
lorsque
it was a key factor
à la technique des
interrogatoires, that the interrogators had to have an absolute stance.
Que les
the people who were arrested had to be regarded as enemy, otherwise the confessions could not be extracted.
Sinon,
this is another main factor. And the second
factor,
once the prisoners agreed to confess, then the interrogation cadres had to ask them to write their biography. From the time of their involvement in the traitorous activities, the date, their detailed activities, for instance. So when they talked about their traitorous activities,
lorsque l'on parlait des activités de trahison,
they would extract the names of those who were implicated in the confession. So usually the comrades knew how to extract and write. And if they did not know how to write, then I would ask them to tape the confession and I asked somebody else to transcribe it. So that was a method of interrogation, first on the traitorous activities and on their personal involvement in the traitorous activities and on the people who were implicated in that confession. So these are the forms of the confession implemented at S21. The President, in interrogating a prisoner during one time, how many interrogators were involved? Was there only one interrogator, two or more?
Interrogateur par interrogatoire,
the accused, Mr.
Deux
President,
ou plus l'accusé, Monsieur
in
le Président,
principle,
en principe,
there was no more than one
interrogator
for each interrogation.
Pour chaque interrogatoire.
However, if
cependant,
it was possible that one interrogator could interrogate more than one prisoner. So
interroger
he
plus
could interrogate a prisoner, and when the confession could not be extracted, he sent the prisoner back, and then another prisoner was brought in to be interrogated with the approval from Camarade Four. So usually only one interrogator at one time.
Donc, Il n'y avait pas plus d'un interrogateur à chaque interrogatoire, à chaque
you
fois.
You just stated
le président.
The interrogation.
Vous venez de parler de.
If the prisoner agreed to confess to write
si
the confessions, then the interrogator would ask the prisoner to write the confessions by himself or herself.
For such process, qu'il ou qu'elle écrive de lui-même ou d'elle-même ses aveux.
It required the interrogator to instruct the prisoner to write on their confessions according to the forms, for example, about their treacherous activities, about their personal involvement, and about the persons who were to be
implicated. Les personnes mises en cause.
The accused, Mr. President. The treacherous activities that a prisoner had to confess had to be in chronological order before, at present, and after. So there was no exact form. It was just the chronology of their treacherous activity.
Il s'agissait de décrire la chronologie des activités de trahison.
The president.
Le président.
Were there any cases where the prisoners?
Des cas où les prisonniers
who were interrogated and were illiterate and could not write the confessions. If there were such cases, what was the process?
Écrire. Et dans de tels cas, quelle était la procédure à suivre?
On this matter, yes, it happened constantly.
L'accusé.
From what I can recall,
sur ce point, oui, c'est quelque chose qui
when such a case happened, then the confessor would have to speak and the voice would be taped.
La personne interrogée devait parler,
and then the cadre would transcribe from the tape and to send it to the upper echelon.
Devait, retranscrire
what about timing?
Et présenter son contenu
for the interrogation that was done at S21, how was the schedule like?
Et du calendrier,
the time allocation,
de l'emploi du temps
for
des
interrogation of those prisoners,
du temps affecté pour l'interrogatoire des prisonniers.
How did the interrogators arrange the time?
De quelle manière les interrogateurs s'organisaient-ils en termes d'emploi du temps?
The accused, Mr. President,
l'accusé,
it was their
président.
Daily routine of the interrogation cadres. They started from 7 a.m. until 11 a.m. This is from what I can recall.
De 7 heures à 11
and
heures
in
matin.
The afternoon, from 2 to
et
4 or 5 p.m.
À 17 heures
and at night, from 7 to 10 p.m. They were busy during these three shifts. That was the daily routine of the interrogation cadres.
Les interrogateurs travaillaient. Tel était le programme de travail quotidien.
The president,
le président.
Normally, to interrogate one prisoner,
pour interroger un prisonnier,
the interrogator had to
l'interrogateur
allocate the time or the frequency of each prisoner. For example, for each prisoner, he or she would be interrogated twice or three times, or was it based on the outcome of the interrogation or based on the confession?
Ou sur la base du
the
contenu
accused, Mr. President,
des aveux.
The frequency
l'accusé
of interrogation,
ce qui est de la fréquence de des interrogatoires,
and the time required was based on the confession. If a confession that I deemed was adequate, then the interrogation would finish. However, for some important or very important prisoners, such as Koitun, the interrogation
cas, comme Koi
was
Thun,
done
Koi Thun,
five times. I did it two times, and then I, the upper echelon, assigned Kamrad Bon to continue questioning again.
Puis
so
l'échelon supérieur
it
a
all based on their confessions, whether we were satisfied with the confession and whether the upper echelon satisfied with the confessions.
L'échelon supérieur
so that was the process.
Était satisfait du résultat. Donc voilà, tel était le processus.
the president.
Le président.
So can we conclude that the people who were assigned to interrogate prisoners would base on the key prisoners, and there would not be any actual time frame for asking any particular prisoner. It depends on when you review the confession, and that more interrogations would be needed. Do I understand that correctly?
Satisfaisant ou si the accused, plus de temps était nécessaire,
Your Honor, it is true.
L'accusé, c'est exact, Monsieur le Président.
The president.
Le président.
Were there any repetitious
y avait-il
interrogations
des
to
interrogatoires
a particular
répétitifs
prisoner, and that the prisoner was subjected to write several and repetitious confessions before the confession would be used?
Prisonnier devait écrire des aveux de
the
manière
accused.
Répétée.
Your Honor, this kind of thing took place continuously, and sometimes the confession would only go through Comrade Ho, and then they would go to me, and of course it's under our supervision to make sure the confession would be certified before they would be used.
Nous assurer que les aveux soient satisfaisants de manière à pouvoir
être utilisés.
Le président,
time,
selon vos observations à l'époque,
were the confessions obtained reflecting the truth?
Est-ce que les aveux obtenus reflétaient la vérité?
The accused,
l'accusé,
all interrogations and the confessions, I never considered them as the truth, because even when I was once detained in the jail, I never confessed the whole truth.
En prison, eh bien moi,
and
à ce moment-là, je n'ai jamais,
I could conclude that
admis la vérité.
The confession
jamais avoué
would only constitute to like the most 50% truth,
and
the people who were implicated, the content, the essence of the truth would be much less than that. Maybe it was only 20%, as I can guess. And the upper echelons would feel the same thing, like I felt, for example, like they did not believe fully in those confessions extracted. For example, when Koytun implicated a cadre known well to me, and I asked for the exemption, I mean for the release or for an exception that the person should not be arrested, but my superior said, look, this was in the confession of a Kun or the contemptible Kun, and you had to be careful because anyone implicated in any confession would be another case, but when Koytun implicated any person's name in his confession, that implication was very convinced. That's why I personally, although I did not believe that the confession was not really genuine, some certain confessions were true, I mean for the key people. And however, Pol Pot at one point did not even believe that the confessions were of truth information.
La teneur des aveux reflétait des informations véridiques.
Correction, the president.
Le président.
Mr. Kangek-il, regarding the functioning of S21.
S'agissant du fonctionnement de S21.
In which situation or cases that you yourself had to be involved in interrogating the detainees personally, and how many cases were there if there were?
Que vous avez dû mener personnellement.
The accused, Mr. President. When I was the deputy chairman, I worked went with NAD. At that time, there was a reaction from Chit Yu, and I was I could not stand, but I had to interrogate Ming Qing.
Je ne pouvais pas supporter cela,
and I had to interrogate him personally and directly, and later on, Chit Yu gave in to my interrogation, and then he walked away. But I noticed that Nat would like to fight or to beat that person, but I noticed also that he had a high rank in the police.
Il occupait un rang.
So I only slapped into the face of Chit Yu, and because I knew that he gave in to my interrogation already, that I would not beat him much. Of course, when the person did not admit that they made mistakes, then it would not be good to beat them because they would react immediately. And when I interrogated Goitun, I interrogated him two times, the first and the second. But after these two interrogations, Bon was assigned to interrogate him because I did not want to be involved in interrogating him any more, although I annotated on the annotations on the confessions of Man San, alias Ya, and Siet Chai, alias Tum. And my superior also noted through the letters to pay attention to these two people. I did not interrogate directly these people. I only interrogated Khoi Thun personally, but I also once interrogated Chit Yu once. And when it comes to the interrogation of Man Yan, alias Ya, and alias Tum, I was also involved.
J'ai participé.
The President, what was the significance or importance of the confession from Khoi Thun that you needed to personally and directly involved in interrogating him? So what was his role in the Democratic Cambodia and in the CPK regime in particular?
Le régime du PCK en particulier.
The accused, Mr. President.
Monsieur le Président.
The role of Khoi Thun in the party,
le rôle de Khoi Thun dans le
I think he already confessed in his confession, or maybe from the confession of Man San, he was the ninth person in the CPK.
C'était une personne proéminente.
He was the member, the full right member of the party, and the ninth person. At the beginning, before the 17th of April 1975, he was the secretary of the North Zone, and later on he was the secretary of the... The President, Mr. Kang Kek Yew, could you please repeat the last statement because interpreter found it rather fast to interpret properly? The accused, Mr. President, Khoi Thun,
L'accusé,
in his role in the party was the full-time member of the party center.
So from Pol Pot to Khoi Thun,
of course Khoi Thun was number 9.
Khoi Thun, sûr,
before the 17th of April 1975, Khoi Thun was the secretary of the committee of the party in the old North Zone. After the 17th of April, the party presented him or appointed him as the secretary of the State Commerce Committee. So this was the significance of his role, but the reason why he humiliated the party in the eyes of the world and the party, because he killed a person named Long, and Long's wife worked with him, and he threatened the other people in his office, and the party decided to suspend him. His activities had been tracked down long ago. That's why on the 25th of December 1976, Khoi Thun was arrested and sent to S21. My superior was prepared and prepared me to be ready to question the person, Khoi Thun. He prepared my position and stance to be strong enough to challenge that person. And the confession of Khoi Thun, I would like to repeat also that he wrote for about 5 pages. I made a copy of such confession immediately, and then asked Comrade Pon, the messenger of Sun Sen, to bring them to Sun Sen. So I did not review the paper, but my superior was be quick to call to get the material. So
je les ai transmis aussi vite que possible à mon supérieur.
I think that's all my submission.
Voilà, je crois.
The president, what about the other two people?
Qu'en est-il des deux autres Chai,
alias Tum,
alias Tum,
and another person until you were required by the upper echelon to closely interrogate these people.
Vous a demandé d'interroger également,
you did not need, you don't need to talk about the activities, you only elaborate about their roles. Why were they important that you were ordered by the superior to closely monitor the interrogators who were interrogating these two people?
Contrôler de façon plus directe les interrogatoires
the accused, Mr. President, Man San alias Yar, was the member, the full tribe member of the party center. He was the 10th person, so after Khoi Thun. Before the 17th April 1975, he was the member of the ammunition transport team crossing to Vietnam, and later on he was the deputy secretary of the general staff, and later on he was appointed as the secretary of the northeast zone. That's why the superior paid good attention to Ya, because they were suspicious that these people had any connection with the Vietnam Communist Party. And Siet Chai alias Tum was the member of the candidate member of the party center even during the previous Congress. In 1976, there was another Congress. He was not yet appointed as the full-time member because he had affiliation with the Vietnamese, but he was appointed to monitor the logistics. And later on, he was appointed as the member of the general staff.
De l'état-major.
Okun.
The president, thank you.
Le président, merci.
Luke, thank you.
Mr. Kangaio. What do you think,
Monsieur Kangaio,
about the identification in a document regarding the records of confession of Li Pel? In that record, it states that the first interrogator was
Duc. Qu'avez-vous à nous dire à ce sujet?
In Li Pal confession, ERN in Khmer 001726. I repeat, 001726888 through 001727771. In English, ERN 002231 through 002231 41. In French,
et en français,
ERN 002960 36 through 0029.
À 002960.
I think we have the same ERN number. Yes, 002960 36.
36 également.
We only focus on one page. ERN number 001727738.
Dans la version Khmer.
The greffier, do you have the copied version of this document to be distributed to the accused regarding the last page,
001727738?
The co-prosecutors, are you able to project this document
et peut-on afficher
on the screen?
Ce document? Est-ce que les coprocureurs peuvent le faire retrouver le document sur l'ordinateur?
The accused said the president, can you explain again, that when you became the chairman of S21,
vous êtes un jour devenu directeur de S21.
Were you involved in interrogating the prisoners?
Vous avez participé.
Because you said that when you was the deputy chairman, you interrogated Chit Yu, who was interrogated by Nat, but Nat failed to interrogate him, that's why you took charge. But you said later that you only interrogated Khoi Thun. And then you said that the superior asked you to closely monitor two other people, Elias Ya and Elias Tum. And on the 17th of September 1976, in this statement, it states clearly that the first interrogator was Deutsch and the second interrogator was Bonn. Could you please elaborate further on your roles here as the interrogator? The accused, Mr. President.
Oui, Monsieur le Président.
This document, if it is projected on the monitor, in Khmer writing, it
si
would be good because the Khmer writing will reveal whether the writing belonged to me, obviously. So,
si, c'est mon écriture ou non.
The president, the co-prosecutor, could you please put the faire apparaître IRN in Khmer 00172738 on the monitor regarding the confession of Li Pell.
Il s'agit des aveux de Li Pell.
Yes, Your Honor, we have it on our screens. I would just ask that the AV switch to the prosecution desk.
Je vais vous demander aux techniciens de faire apparaître cette image à l'écran général.
The President, the audio and visual unit, can you link the co-prosecutor's computer
to be projected on the screen?
The President, the accused, you can read the few letters on the screen. This is the last page of the document.
Le président, je demanderai à l'accusé de
lire. As I have said, based on your response, there were only a few people that you interrogated. But in this record of the interview, it was clearly stated that the first interrogator was you, Deutsch. How would you explain to the chamber on this particular document? The accused, Mr. President, my annotation was on the typed document.
Oui, c'est une annotation portée sur le document dactylographié.
And I still maintained that
my
annotation was done under the order of my superior.
Annotation a été portée ici the superior wanted mon supérieur voulait
more than one interrogator. For example, the interrogators of Li Pell at Sector 21
before
the individual
21.
Was transferred to S21, there were nine interrogators who interrogated Li Pell. And I only saw that document during the interrogation period. Let me return to this document. Comrade Bond interrogated the person, and when I have the document, then the superior said, now you also put your name on this document, and put the date at the 17th of September 76, and the interrogators, first interrogators, was me, I signed with my name, and for the second interrogator, because I could not sign for Bond, I only wrote his name. This is purely my annotation, not Bond handwriting. And if Bond was the second interrogator, then Bond would also have signed the document. Because I was a senior than Bond, then it would be Bond who would write or annotate on the document. I only made annotation on this document with the instruction from my superior in order for this document to be sent to the East Zone. So I can confirm that this is my handwriting, and I did it based on instruction from the superior. And the third one is to reflect that we also use more than one interrogator to interrogate as it was a practice in the East Zone. This is my report to you, Your Honor. Mr. President, thank you.
Le président, merci.
Now it is time for a break.
Il est temps maintenant de faire une pause.
It is also time to change the DVD
ainsi
for the recording, and the chamber
DVD
will adjourn for 20 minutes until 11 a.m. when the chamber will resume.